Hey everyone, how's it going? Brian here with another Java game programming tutorial. So the last time we left off, we spruced up our game and made it look pretty cool. We got this background, the tower's background here. Make sure you download that from the video description of the last video. And we can place our towers, but unfortunately, if you are following along with my own pace here, we can place towers on the water, which doesn't make much sense, at least not in my mind. Not only that, but we could place towers on top of other towers. Or we could place the same tower on towers and have a huge like machine gun by placing them over and over. And we're going to fix that in this video. It's actually a pretty simple fix. And in fact, we already planned for this in a previous episode. If you look at our tile type class down here. By the way, we're going to be working in the player class and the tile class. And just looking at the tile type real quick, we already have a boolean called buildable in here, which we never use, which is surprising because the tile type class right now just holds a texture name and a boolean. So it's pretty important as far as this class is considered. It's about half of its functionality is whether or not we can build on that tile type. So we're going to implement that tile type finally, or that part of the tile type functionality finally, in the player class. Currently, when we place our tower, we call a method called placeTower. How appropriate. And it checks if we're holding a tower, which we probably are, because placeTower is called when we click our mouse, I believe. Yeah, if mouse button's down 0, which is the left click, oops, gain a text, then call placeTower. So we call it right here, and then we check inside here if we're holding a tower. If we're not, we're obviously not going to do anything. We're just clicking on the board for some reason. And if we are holding a tower, then we're going to call a method called modifyCache, and we're going to pass in tempTower.getCost. Now, if you'll recall, the way this works is modifyCache is a custom method we made up here. ModifyLives, modifyCache. So modifyCache is a very simple method. It takes an integer as an argument called amount, and we are passing in as an amount tempTower.getCost. Now remember, tempTower is picked with this method here, where we pass in a tower, we set temp tower equal to that tower, and we say we are now holding a tower. Temp tower to get cost is part of our tower type enum. So in tower type, we set the texture, the projectile type, damage, range, and cost. And so, of course, we call it from our tower class where we have a get cost method, but it's just directly getting it from our tower type right here. So in our player class, we then check if we're holding a tower, which we are, if modify cache and we send in the cost of that tower, what modify cache does, and I'm just kind of reviewing here because we're going to be changing it, kind of refreshing your memory. We are checking if we can actually afford the tower first. So modify cache, maybe it's a bit of a misnomer. In fact, I'll put a comment here. We'll check if player can afford tower. If so, reduce, or how about like process transaction, whatever terminology makes sense for you. I'll say charge player tower cost. Because modify cache might make it sound like we're just changing the cache, but we're actually also doing a check here. We're making sure we can afford it first. We don't want to be in debt, right? This game is not supposed to mimic real life. Ha! Not so funny. If cache plus amount is greater than or equal to 0, then cache plus equals amount. Now, this might seem kind of unintuitive at first, but you need to keep in mind that we are almost always passing in here, at least in the context of making towers, a negative value. So even though we're adding it, we're checking if it's above 0. So we'll say, you know, that the tower cost might be negative 50. So we'll say our current cache plus negative 50, if that is still above 0, if we still can afford that, then go ahead and process that. Reduce our cache by 50 and return true, as in we can afford that and we processed it. Otherwise, return false, we can't afford that. So I'm going over all that for a reason, because we're going to be changing the way placeTower works a little bit. We're going to be doing another check right here on line 100, or my line 100, where we say if modify cache, get the cost, add the tower. And the reason we're changing it is because the way this currently works is, I guess we'll do a different order. Let's first check that we can actually build on the tile and let's check if another tower is currently on the tile. So the way I'm going to do that is in the tile class here, we're going to make another variable. It's going to be a Boolean, and I'm going to name it, occupied. Occupied just means that there's another tower on this tile, there's a tower on this tile currently. And we will set it with an if statement. We'll say if type dot buildable, and we don't need to check that with anything. It returns a Boolean. Type.buildable is a Boolean, so it'll be either equal to true or false. So we could say if type.buildable is equal to true. It's the same thing as just saying if type.buildable. If it's buildable, then we'll start occupied as false, else we'll say occupied is true. Now, we could do this different ways. Say there's a scenario where a tile is buildable on, but we don't want to build towers on it. We'll have to get into those specific scenarios later. Right now, we're just setting the default value of occupied equal to true if we can't build on it. So for the purpose of our player, if we want to build on the water, we're just going to say there's already an invisible tower there. It's already occupied. It's occupied by sea monsters. You can't build there. So now we have that new variable here, we need to find a way to access it. It's a private Boolean. So we need to make a getter and setter at the bottom here. We'll do the getter first. Public Boolean get occupied. And we're going to return occupied. And then the setter, public void set occupied. They'll take a Boolean named occupied. We're just going to set this.occupied equal to occupied. We've done that before, right? Go to the player class. And now, in addition to checking if modify cache, if we can afford it, we're also going to check. Maybe we should store the tile that we're working with first. We have this handy method called getMouseTile. So right at the start of place tile or place tower, we're going to make a new tile named, current tile equal to getMouseTile. Now remember, the mouse tile will always be what we're checking here because we're placing the tower. So it's the very instant that we click, our mouse will obviously be over the tile that we're trying to click on. So current tile equals get mouse tile. We want to check if we can afford it, and we want to check if current tile dot get occupied. Now this would mean that it is occupied, so we shouldn't be able to build there. So in order to say, again, we could either say is equal to false, or we could say is not equal to true. But if you remember, just this on its own returns a Boolean, so just this means true. So instead of saying not equal to true like that, we can just put an exclamation point in front of it. And that's the same thing as saying not this. So as in, this is not true, meaning it's not occupied, meaning we can build on it. Okay? So let's go ahead and try that first. We're going to need to make another adjustment. Some of you might already see ahead of time a possible issue with this, but we're going to go ahead and try it first. We're going to run the game, hit play, tower, put on the grass, see if that still works. It does. Put on the water, it doesn't work. It disappears, which we might not want, because it might give the player the impression that they're being charged, which, spoiler alert, they are. But first, let's fix that disappearing. Let's copy these two lines right here, where we set holding tower equal to false and temp tower equal to null. Copy them, delete them, and we're going to extend this if statement. So far, we just have one line for the if statement, so there's no brackets around it. We're going to make brackets, and after we add the tower to the tower list, we're going to paste those two lines. Okay? So now let's go ahead and hit play, or run, and grass again. And now when we try to do it on the water, it shouldn't place it, but it also shouldn't make it disappear. All right? That should be working. Doing the grass, it works. Now the problem is, as I spoiled a second ago, and as some of you may have already picked up on, that even though we're not placing the tower, if we click a bunch, I started at a bunch of cash because I was cheating. I'm not sure how much cash you guys are starting at, but if I click a bunch, I'm actually charging myself every time I click here. Even though it's not placing the tower, I'm getting charged because of the modify cache method. So if I click a bunch, I'm not placing any tower, and I try to place in the grass. Okay, well, that I just killed a guy, so bad example. Let's kill this guy. All right, click a bunch. Can't place in the grass now. Can't afford it, right? When you kill a guy, I can't afford it because I get money from that. But trust me that it is charging every time you try to place it on the water or somewhere that you can't place it. Same thing if you try to place it on another tower, too. Ooh, interesting. It's actually placing there. Oh, that's why. It's because we're not actually setting it to occupied when we place the tower. So right if we add the tower here, we'll just go ahead and say current tile dot set occupied to true. So now when we run, we can place it in the grass. We cannot place it in the water, and we also cannot place it on another tower. Okay, but we are still being charged every time we click here. In fact, if I show the screen over here and I click a bunch, you can see I have zero money in the console down here. I get five and try to place it again. Can't afford it. I think they cost 10, is that right? I don't know. Anyways, it's trying to charge us every time we place the tower, even though we can't place another tower. Very easy fix here. And I don't know if we've covered this specifically, but if you've done other programming, you might understand what we're about to do here. Line 101 in this check, we can fix this by doing one simple switch here. The way if statements work and the way this operand and works is it evaluates the first expression first, right? The one on the left, it evaluates this first, and then it evaluates this one if the first one was true. So we're pretty much saying, if this is true, and also this is true, then do everything in the if statement, right? It's different from saying if this and this is true, like as in together. So in order to fix this, all we need to do is just switch this, go ahead and copy that get occupied, and we're gonna put it in front of the modify cache. Put the and there. We're just switching positions. And so what that does is it says, if the tile is not occupied, then do the modify cache method. Check if we can afford it. If we can, charge the player. And that should fix our issue where it was charging us for placing it where we couldn't place it. So I'll place the tower here. I have 185 cash left. If I click a bunch, you can see it's no longer trying to charge me in the console down there. Of course, we shouldn't have to look at the console. We should probably just get a text, a way to write text in our game. I think we're a little bit over two for that. So maybe, I don't know about next episode, but I think soon here we're going to start writing text. That's going to open up a lot of possibilities for us, like tracking our lives, our cash, our wave number, lots of stuff. So text will definitely, it's on the horizon here, but at least now we're following our own rules, right? We implemented this buildable variable forever ago and never really used it, and now we're using it. So I think that's it for this episode. Thanks a lot for watching, everyone. Make sure to check out patreon.com/indieprogrammer if you want to support the series. It's great help. And I will see you all next time.